So if you missed my super subtle hint, today is all about relationship. Now that's a little bit of a jump off from today's day in the series, right? Because we're in the middle of this amazing, wonderful series about igniting our faith practices, about breathing life into what we're doing in the church so that we can really connect with God and with each other and with our community, so that our faith is something we're passionate about, that's powerful, and that's transforming our life. And today's topic on the list of transformative faith practices is actually stewardship. So the Stewardship Sunday, talking about giving our resources, sharing our resources, our connection to the church, and how we make sure it's sustainable, and how it's able to grow and do mission in the community. How do we go from stewardship to relationship? Well, I'll tell you, I have a really, really good friend. And the way that I knew that we were a really good friend was the day she asked me for $20. And I just said, yeah, sure. Because it didn't occur to me to ask myself, do I have this $20 to spare? How soon is she going to be able to give it back? Am I going to, you know, what is she going to use it for? Do I trust her to use this money for good? Or is it going, you know, is it going down the rabbit hole? You know, I ask some questions when people ask me for money. I do. But with this woman, it didn't occur to me. Because I trusted her. And I knew that whatever it wasn't up to me to be questioning, to be judging. Because to me, relationship is a space without judgment. It's a space of support and care where if I got, you got. If you need, I'm going to find a way to get it for you. And if we're going to share that one pizza together, I'm not going to eat my pizza and knowing that you're over there hungry. I'm not going to do it. That connection of caring for each other is where money stops mattering. It's not about what you have. It's not about even what you give, because you've stopped keeping track. We probably swapped that 20 back and forth so many times, nobody knows who owes who what anymore. We just know that if somebody needs a Uber or a cab, if somebody needs food, if somebody needs clothes, if we're just eating and it's too much work to figure out a check, girl, I got you. Because that's what real, non-judgmental, loving, caretaking relationship means. And our scriptures today, this passage from Isaiah, I mean, did you let that roll around in your heart for a minute when you heard it? Because this to me is one of the most beautiful pieces of poetry in the Bible. And what it says about relationship, it just makes me fall in love with God all over. The coastlands have seen, and they're drawing near and coming. I mean, the very earth is pulling closer to each other. God's creation is so in love with God that it recognizes that it's called to be in relationship with itself. The shorelines are encouraging each other and saying, take courage. God's creation is encouraging and uplifting itself because it recognizes that we are all connected. Now, if shorelines are lifting each other up and encouraging, tell us to tell the truth moment, how often are you looking at your other siblings in Christ and saying, be encouraged, be of good heart, let me draw closer to you, let me love on you, let me wrap around you and support you because we are in this together. This passage in Isaiah is reminding us that even the earth is doing that. And why? You know, because God is a good and generous and loving God who spells it out for us because God knows we can be a little slow. You, who I have chosen, you're the offspring of Abraham, my friend. Not, you know, the person who dusts felt such despair or hopelessness or loneliness or sadness or fear that you felt like even God couldn't see you, let me know, because maybe I'm the only one. Maybe I'm up here alone. Okay, so I'm not. And God knew that. And so God wrote this right out. You are my friend. I have chosen you. And I will not cast you off. Written right there, black and white, clear as day. I have chosen you, and I will not cast you off. This is about relationship. This is what we're to look at as a model for how we are to connect with people. This is not about allowing someone to hurt you or abuse you or take advantage of you. I want to make that very clear. Because sometimes you may need to protect yourself and your family and those you love. But that doesn't mean that you stop praying. That doesn't mean you stop hoping for. That doesn't mean you stop loving. Because God doesn't cast us off, and so we don't cast off God, and we don't cast off the creations of God. We stay in relationship, because that's what we're called to do. And God says that God's going to take care of us through that process. Do not fear. I'm with you. Don't be afraid, because why? Because I am your God. I'm going to read that one more time, because it gives me chills. Do not fear. I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you. That's relationship. That's a connected relationship. That's not transaction. That's not you do this, I'll do that. That's not you earn this, I'll reward you with that. This is not God gives a cookie. This is love. This is love, my friends. But here's the thing about love. And again, maybe I'm the only one up here, I don't know. You ever felt what it feels like to love someone? To pour out your whole heart to them. To love them as close as you can to the way that Christ loves them. But they don't give it back. You're pouring out your love, your generosity, you're giving a lack of judgment, you're giving acceptance, you're giving patience and forgiveness and forgiveness and probably a little more forgiveness. And you don't receive that back. And I see the heads moving, so I know I'm not the only one up here. But think about how that makes you feel. How does it make you feel when you poured out the love of Christ and of your whole heart? And it was just left where it went. Fortunately, that's what we do to God on the regular. And I'm not even going to call you out. I can just stop right here in this pulpit. I can say, I've done it. I can say, when I didn't know how I was going to get out of bed in the morning and somehow I did, the first thing I did when I put my feet on the floor was not to say thank you, Jesus. I can say that blessings upon blessings were poured out on me. I was still fussing about the other parts of my life that were still hard. Well, yes, I know I've got all these wonderful good people in my life. I know I've got a car that drives. I know that, but you know what? I'm struggling. I'm still tired. Oh, my back's hurting today. Oh, it's raining out. I don't want to get wet. And you know, my hair and the rain are not friends. I mean, I can find all kinds of things to be ungrateful for. Almost like I was a broken person in a broken world. Oh, I like that. I like the joke. So, we're not necessarily giving up our end of the bargain. God doesn't stop reaching out to us. Because that's what you do when you love someone. The Bible is full of stories of people that tried, that failed, that fell short. But you know what the Bible is not full of? A God that said, well, you missed that boat, I'm out. It's full of a God that tries to reach us again and again and again. And so when we talk about stewardship, when we talk about the relationship of caring for each other, that's the model right there. We are not called over and over and over again. We just got three passages today, but there are hundreds we could have used. We got an act, rope for God. Not just kind of reach out your hand and if God happens to be close. We got rope for God and bind God. This is not a deity made of stone. This is not someone still. This is a God that is living and loves you and is reaching out for you too. In our gospel, we got that life is so much more than the physical things. We got that it is about relationship and connection. We are called to be in relationship, to love, and to love back. And when you love back, our kids told us right up here, they got it. We don't give to get, right? Think about the people that you love. Think about the relationships that have real meaning in your life. Would you still have that marriage, that friendship, that connection with your child, your grandchild, your godchild, your godparent, your grandparent? Would you still have that relationship if you only gave when you got something back? Of course not. What about when you give to fix? Right? Because we like that. We like that in the church. And we like to evaluate. You know, we're going to judge our ministries. Right? And I'm going to say, I was the first one. I was guilty of that for a long time. Well, I'm not giving to that nonprofit because I read about how much their CEO takes. And you know what? That's really not my issue. I'm much more passionate about this issue this week. I'm going to do that over here. And I don't know about this church. You know, I don't know if I like how they're spending their money. You know, I don't like the pastor. I don't approve the car the pastor drives. You know? And the thing, this is what's messed up. He drives too nice a car. We say he's got too much money. He doesn't drive a nice enough car. We say, well, he doesn't know what he's doing with his money. You see the trap that judgment can get you into? Because that's about making giving, making relationship, making connection into a transaction. You don't fill out a deposit slip in the bank of salvation. Like, Jesus, I donated this much, and so I would like an excellent seat on the top circle of heaven, please. I paid for a box seat. We all get mansions. You read it or you know. We don't give to get. We don't give out of obligation. We don't give to fix because we've decided what needs fixing. Because we're judging over whether something has merit or not. We don't give based on the project. We give to be in relationship, to be connected. Because we are trying every way we can to show up. And that's when stewardship becomes about a lot more than money. Right? Because are all you are what you got in your wallet? I'm pretty sure the Bible verses said you're a lot more than that. You are your time. You are your talent. You are your love and your compassion. But yes, you are also your resources. You are your sweat equity and your labor. Sometimes you are moving a box. I don't ever want to say yes, but my friend says, I'm moving. I got a pickup. I got some empty boxes. Who got me? I never were like, ooh, yay. But you know what? I show up. Because that's what you do when you're in a relationship. I am not always excited when I gotta hit my little QR code and be like, ooh, there's a dinner out I'm not having tonight. But you know what? I'm about showing up. And I don't always show up the way I should. Not frustrated and I say something that I really wish I could take back. But luckily, I'm in relationship with a God who is also in relationship with me, who continues to give, who continues to love, who continues to care, who especially continues to forgive. And I love being in relationship with God. I love loving my Jesus. I love that there is something that I'm a part of that's bigger than just me, that I know that I'm not alone in this world, because it can be so cold and lonely, and I know that y'all have felt that with me. But at no point in time am I alone, because wherever I go, all of you are with me. This body of Christ that we're connected in, there is no alone anymore, because I'm connected to each one of you. I'm connected to the saints that have passed away. I'm connected to the churches over in Tanzania and the churches in the Congo and the Sudan. We are worshiping the same God together. There is no alone. Now that I'm in Christ, I'm in relationship. And that means I gotta show up. I gotta do my part. In a broken world, there's always gonna be something broken. There's always going to be people in need. There's always gonna be a project that we need to do. There's always gonna be something we need to work on fixing. But that is not what our stewardship, what our giving is about. Our giving is about love. Because at the end of the day, isn't that what everything we do is about? God loves us. We do our best to love God back because we are in relationship and in connection. And one of the best ways we can love God is loving each other. Loving on these other people that God loves. So yeah, I'm absolutely going to ask you, without judgment, without condemnation, without nitpicking and thinking about this and criticizing and saying, I want to see those balance sheets, I'm going to ask you to give. Not to me, not to Pastor Joel, not to Matt, not to an organ leather interior. I'm going to ask you to give to God. Because it's a way to care for the church that you're a part of. I'm going to ask you to give of your time. I know you're working. I know you're tired. But I'm going to ask you to find some of those talents that God has given you and figure out a way to use them for kingdom work. I'm going to ask you to give by pushing yourself and your kindness just a little bit further than feels comfortable. I'm going to ask you to show up for your siblings in Christ. Because relationships are work. How many of y'all are in a relationship that has been perfectly easy and smooth all the time? Well, see, now I got no hands. Amen. Okay. Oh, all right. We got one back. All right. I see you. I don't have any relationships, not the good, deep, long ones that were perfect all the time, every day. It's work. It's work. But I'll tell you what, without him, without any of those relationships, life ain't worth it. So I push myself and try to show up. And I'm going to ask you to do the same. We don't give to save the world. We give to save ourselves. We give as an act of faith. We give as an act of gratitude. Give, I'm going to have you finish this one with me, because this is our big word. We give is an act of what?
Nice.
Love. We give as an act of love. I hope that you're feeling our services, this last series, that your faith practices are growing and deepening, because they hopefully all come back to love. But this week, I'm challenging you to go out and figure out how you're giving, how you're in relationship, how you're connected. stronger, better, and greater than what we could do alone. Amen, church?